Tonight, forgiveness or a double standard? Prominent evangelical leaders on the record giving President Trump a pass on recent allegations of a sexual affair with a porn star and reports of paying her off in return to silence her.
He's not the same person now that he was back then. I believe he's changed. What they don't understand about evangelicals is our whole faith is based on the theology of forgiveness.
He wanted to have the support of evangelicals, and he came to them saying, I'm going to pro-life justices. I'm picking a pro-life conservative running mate, and he embraced himself in the most conservative party platform ever. And yes, evangelicals, conservatives gave him a mulligan. They let him have a do-over.
Mulligan. Out front now, Jerushah Armfield. She is the granddaughter of Billy Graham, one of the world's best-known evangelists. Jerusha, you heard those comments there, Tony Perkins, Jerry Falwell Jr. Do you agree that Trump gets a pass?
Obviously, our faith believes in forgiveness. I think in order to forgive somebody, that individual needs to repent and apologize. And I don't think America has seen that from our president in any scenario, really.
I have to ask this, and this is sort of a parlor game, but it's a fair question. What if this had been President Obama, who'd had an extramarital affair years before office with a porn star, paid her off for her silence? Could you imagine your grandfather, your uncle, Tony Perkins, saying the same thing?
I think the reality, Jim, is I think we all know the answer to that question. I don't think that any of the prior world leaders have been forgiven for anything by some of these evangelicals. I think the question you're asking is the exact same question that I'm asking, and I think the world knows the answer, that nothing these leaders have said or done have illustrated that they would give that forgiveness to, let's say, President Obama in that situation. Had President Obama asked for forgiveness, had he then in humility changed his behavior? Absolutely. I think that's a core of our faith. But you've got to, you know, ask for forgiveness first.
Yeah. Your uncle, Franklin Graham, he also pointed to the fact that the affair, the alleged affair, happened years before Trump took office. Here's what he told my colleague Don Lemon about the president's responsibility as a role model.
Isn't the president supposed to be a role model for all?
Well, you certainly want them to be a role model. But he's a businessman, Don. He's not a politician. He's a businessman. And when he's in business meetings, he talks a certain way. And he's trying to get the point across. But, Don, I believe Donald Trump is a good man. And I believe he's president of the United States for a reason. I think God put him there.
Do you agree with those excuses, your uncle's excuses for President Trump's behavior?
First, I think a lot of times people seem to be focusing on the language that he used, which really wasn't the issue. I don't think that was anybody's issue, was the language that he used. I think it was the context of what he said around the language that he used.
You're talking about the shithole comments on Haiti, yes. Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, for sure. I think they're focusing on the language and making excuses for it when I don't really know that that was anybody's issue to begin with. I think it was, you know, the disheartening, dehumanizing comments that were said around the word. I also think that, you know, I said last time I was on your program, Jim, that my president doesn't have to be a Christian. I just don't want him to be held up as the poster boy for Christian evangelicals because he doesn't represent most of us.
It seems like the trade-off here is essentially political. The evangelical leaders are giving Trump a pass because, and you heard Perkins there say, well, he's got a Christian vice president, policies, for instance, on abortion. Do you think that's a fair trade-off? That in effect those positions outweigh or even erase other behaviors, comments, et cetera, that you've seen and heard from Trump?
No. And I understand a lot of evangelicals supporting him because of his policies. Mm-hmm. I'd love to see a Christian leader come out and say that they support Trump for his policies, but that his behavior disgusts them and he needs to clean up his act. Mm-hmm. I would love to just hear one of them say that, but it seems to be both and. If they support his policies, they also feel like they have to stay hush on his behavior. And I just feel like it's sending the wrong message to the world about what Christianity is and what evangelicals are, or I guess, you know, have become.
Jerusha, just quickly before we go, do you see any evangelical support for the president waning after this first year in office and some of these things they've seen and heard?
From the things that I've seen, no. I see possibly a turn that they will start to speak out a little bit more about some of his behavior. But no, those policies that they're hoping he is going to push through are, they seem kind of paramount right now.
Jerusha, thanks so much for taking the time tonight and speaking so honestly on very difficult issues.
Thanks, Jim.